Guys, welcome to another holiday edition UnTECH video. What does that mean? Is this a special one just for the holidays? No. It means I'm on holiday and I don't have any of my equipment or any of my programs that I use to create those snazzy little entrances and graphics and all those sort of things. So we're going with Loom today. So deal with the audio being a little bit off. Deal with all that because this is going to be a fun one. So today I'm going to show you how to bring instant data scraper functionality back to scraping LinkedIn. Now, a couple months ago, if you were paying attention and you went to use instant data scraper on LinkedIn, you got this notice right here. We're unable to collect data from LinkedIn. Sorry the inconvenience. If you have further questions, please contact us. And if you did contact them, you get a response back saying that they just don't have a budget to battle LinkedIn lawyers. So they disabled the functionality across all of it. Now, this necessitates having a brief discussion on why even bother bringing this functionality back. Are there better programs out there? Sure, there are. You have ZapInfo, which does a really good job of paginating, grabbing the data, and enriching it. You have WebScraper.io, which is a little bit more technical, but can get the job done. There's a slew of other programs that I think, depending on what you want to do with the data, or depending on how much information or how enriched you want the data, this would probably be your last step. However, it did come in really handy when you just wanted to grab, 150 contacts right off the bat. Nothing special, just wanted to grab name, title, and company, and you wanted to do it really quickly, this allows you to do it. But as you see, they disabled it in the most recent version. So we're going to show you step by step easily how to get it back. It's a little bit more of a complicated process, and it does involve kind of grabbing an extension, unpacking it, and repacking it. But we're going to walk through it. So for now, I'm just going to disable Instant Data Scraper, get that out of here. And first thing you're going to do is go to this web page called CRX for Chrome. Now, what's a CRX? It's kind of the packaging, the zip, the compressed file that all extensions are in, and you can import them into Chrome. You'll find a lot of what you see here are ready to be in the Chrome store, a lot easier to download there. However, you will find older versions of extensions. You will find extensions that maybe haven't been approved or have been unapproved or blacklisted from the Chrome extension store. So tread lightly. This doesn't come with some of the same securities that you get when you download an extension directly from Chrome. You're not quite sure what you're getting, and if you don't understand how extensions work, very careful when using this. You never know what you're going to get. So for instance, for this, we're just going to go into the search box and type in Instant Data Scraper and hit search. First thing you notice, basically directs you to a Bing custom search engine. So it doesn't even have internal search capabilities of its own, which I find really funny. And you see a bunch of versions here, right? We see version 1.9, 1.99, and then you see an older version, 1.1.7, which is exactly what we want. So we're going to click on that because this is an older version before that functionality was erased, stopped. And you click on any of these links to download them. I'm gonna go for Google CDN, and there you go. You might get a warning when downloading it. It recognizes could be sort of a weird file. It's okay, I've done it. Not anything bad happened to my computer. And there you go. It has the extension. It's in your downloads file. If I go into my download file, you could see it right here. Boom. Extension 0.1_7. Okay. First step done. If you're with me so far, let's go on to the second step. We're going to go to another web page called CRX Extractor, right? It's a free web page. We're going to get started, and it's going to give us some options. We're going to choose the file we want from the file we just downloaded. So if we go into download, we're going to take that file, click on it, and click download source. Cool. So what it's done is it's now changed it into a file that's more recognizable, a zip file. And you see it right over here, to which we're just going to extract it all, right? It's going to put it into a unique folder. Just for convenience wise, I'm going to rename this folder Instant Data Scraper IDS. I'm going to extract it. Done. You see, it's kind of all the programming, all the JavaScript, all the files that go into an extension, it's all unpacked right over there. So back into our browser, we now have to go import this into our browser. So you're going to go into where you find your extensions, more tools, extensions, click on that. It's going to load up a page here, and you probably need to have your developer mode switched on. You see, I have that right here toggled into, let's see if I can highlight that for you guys right over here, toggled into the on position. And there's a couple of options here, right? There's a pack extension, update, and load unpacked. Well, it's exactly what we want to do, load unpacked. So you're going to direct that directly to your download file, your download directory. And here we have the directory IDS. I'm going to click OK. There you go. And you see it's automatically imported that, and it's actually showed up here, right? So it's already turned on. If we wanted to turn it off, it would simply go away. You notice on the top right over there, and it's back on. Perfect. So now it's back on. Let's go back into our LinkedIn for a second, and let's do a search for recruiters, right? Seems like a nice group of people to pick on. It's going to load up. We're going to go down to people and grab that list right over here. Great. So just for the sake of this, I'm going to scoot myself over to the right-hand side here. And you see you have that all right over here. Click on Instant Data Scraper. It's actually going to load the file. And there you go. It's now identified this entire table. Usually like to scroll down to the bottom, hit try another table just to have it reload that entire table in its full content. And there you go. It's immediately found 10, which is all you get on a page. I'm gonna shift this just to the right over here so you could see what we're getting. And as you know from our previous videos, you're getting their LinkedIn profile. We're getting everything, really. Here's our location. Here's their name. And what else do we have here? And their title, subline level one, as it is laid out on the page. Now, why I think this is pretty easy is you can also, I'm gonna scoot this over here, locate the next button. Tell it where that sort of pagination button is. Go back into and just start crawling, right? So what it's doing is continually hitting next page, next page, next page, next page, and grabbing everything on that, all the contacts on that page. And it's pretty reliable. Not 100%, as you see, there's should be 10 every single time. And they're on rows collected 36, right? So obviously not perfect, but works even better on a recruiter. You know, we've now done it 25 seconds. We have over 50 contacts, and I'm going to stop it right over here. So we got about 60 contacts in just about 30 seconds. It's given us a lot more than we probably need, but you could always go ahead and whittle that down. And as you see, it's got us the names. It's got us the titles, and it's got us where they work as well, plus their LinkedIn profile, which you could then download and put into another program for enrichment if you needed to. But I think it's pretty good. And if you wanted to, you could download it as a CSV file, open it up, and edit it in Excel just to show you sort of everything that you've got in here, which is probably the easier way to do it. All right, enough. Who cares? Using an older version, what could you ask for? And as you see, all their LinkedIn pages, you know, link to their LinkedIn picture, which is obviously irrelevant. We don't need that. Status, whether they're online or offline, don't really care about that. Name and title, location is sort of where I want, and it also has some current ones. Now, of course, it's not perfect. You got name and title on the same line, which you could then use Excel to break apart if you wanted to. but it's pretty good for how the data is generally laid out here. Where you see you're sort of not getting distinct company and title separations on many of these, right? You know, some of these is just in one line and that isn't even a clickable line either. So, you know, pretty good. Can't really complain. Easy way to bring on back. If you did this within, say, LinkedIn Recruiter instead, you'd be able to get cleaner results there. But we'll keep this video short. I won't go over that too much, just to say that you can do it. Well, guys, I hope this helps. And just remember, you know, download it from CRX for Chrome. Use Get CRX Extractor to extract it. Download it, extract it into a directory, and import it into Chrome. And here you go. And if you're wonder how you'll know the difference between that and your other version of Instant Data Scraper, well, you'll notice that there's a little development thing that pops up right in there that shows that it's not an official released, or not an official version of the most updated release, that it is in developer mode. So you'll know whether you have that one on or decide to go with the regular one, which is obviously updated and has those functionalities taken away from it. Well, thanks, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope this helps. And we'll be back in the new year with some more videos on scraping and other automation technology. Thanks for checking out UnTECH video, and see you guys next year.